It's your boy Crypto Blood. Welcome to another, or I should say an updated video. I'm doing an update on my experience with the BitGet platform. That's BitGet.com, BitGet.com. As you guys probably know, I did a video maybe about 3 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago, showing you guys the process of signing up and following one of the copy traders on their platform. So I'm giving you guys an update on that and showing you the progress of that whole experience so far. But before we get started, I do want to let you guys know on BitGet, you've got 2 more days left to sign up for the first King's Cup Global International Trading Competition. You'll join BitGet and get 100 Bitcoins. That's BIT coins, not Bitcoins. It's their own coin on the platform. And you can use those coins for extra perks, less fees, trading fees, and all that. You know how the whole routine goes. You've seen it with Binance and other exchanges. But the registration period ends in 2 days. That's November 4th. So make sure you guys go in and register. And the competition actually goes all the way through the 20th, of this month. So you still have some time to register. And so you may be asking, what is the King's Cup Global International Trading Competition? So basically, the prize pool for this year will be up to 100 Bitcoin. The contest will take the forms of team battle and individual competitions to benefit more participants. There will also be additional seasons such as City Assembly, airdrops for all, post-competition bonuses, and early bird benefits. As you guys can see, they're offering a total of 500 million BGBs, generous trial funds, and classic NFTs. To set up for this, you can do the individual competition. Prize pool is 50 Bitcoin, and you have to trade the unified futures to be eligible. Okay, the requirement, the net worth must be at least 300 USDT. So not much to participate to possibly win 50 Bitcoins. All right, the top 10 participants by P&L will share the 30% of the prize, total prize pool, and the top 10 participants by profits will share 70% of the total prize pool. So you don't have to necessarily be the biggest trader, though they will get 70% of the prize pool. Those are the people who have the biggest profits. However, you can be the biggest P&L percentage participate and get part of the 30% of that. So it doesn't, you know, it can go both ways. So just keep that in mind and get in there and start trading. I'll have a link in the description below for you guys to sign up for that. But back to what I'm doing on BitGet is, it's funny because I'm a trader. I develop algorithms and everything myself, and I may end up putting my own user profile on BitGet.com so you guys can follow my trading strategies. But I'm just testing out other people's trading strategies, and man, I'm pretty surprised at the accuracy and the ease of use. So I'm just going to go over to the copy trading platform. It's at the top there. You'll see copy trade, and then all you want to do is hit the copy trade link right there under the drop down. Once over here, as I've said in other videos, you can select, go through and select a profile that you feel is good for you and fits your risk profile. And you can see their performance over 3 week period. If you actually click on the tile, you'll be able to get more information, like what's their overall percentage P&L. 2400% this guy's been trading for the last 523 days. So very good percentages here, P&L percentage. That is excellent. Total profits, $24,000. So 70 losses versus 166 in gains. Not a bad ratio either, to be honest with you. But this is great. They have so many traders on here. You have a laundry list and a whole bunch to pick from. And you can also filter across the top there, as you guys may be able to see there. But what I want to show you is actually what's going on with the status of my copy trading. So I actually just added another trader profile that I'm following. I found that they were pretty good as well, so I wanted to add them to my system. So look, I put in like $2,200. I've made $450 already. It hasn't even been a month yet. So this is literally just selecting a copy trader and letting their system do the work. Amazing, right? The one thing that I want to just emphasize here, guys, and when you're actually setting up and following a copy trader, you must look when you select the one you want to go with. This is what I suggest you do. So you'll see the futures that this particular trader is utilizing in their strategy. All of these, right? So you can keep these all checked if you want. The main thing you want to make sure you do is unified setting so that you don't have to customize each trading pair in his strategy. Just use a unified strategy and allow yourself to select a global setting for all of the pairs that this particular person is trading. On top of that, I would suggest you use the futures settings for your leverage mode and also a fixed ratio. You can do one would be the same as the person's copy trade amount. So if they're, you know, placing 10 contracts on the table, you'll do 10 contracts with them. So no difference than what they're doing. If you're feeling a little lucky, maybe two times or 1.5, you can do 1.5. That'll be 50% more of the number of trading contracts. But starting out, just to be on the safe side, I would say at one. And as you build your profits up, then you can double or triple however much more you want to be more aggressive with the trading. So that's what I would suggest doing. But the most important part is what I want to show you guys is you have to transfer funds over to the futures. Right now, I don't have any funds in my spot USDT account because they're all in my swap futures accounts, all of these. If you've deposited money, funded your account, your BitGet account in USDT, then you want to select USDT at the top and then transfer from your spot account. That's where it will be. If you deposited USDT into your account, it will be in your spot account. So you want to transfer a little bit over into your Bitcoin, a little bit over into your EOS, ETH, LTC, etc., so that when a trade is initiated from whichever one that this particular copy trader is starting a new trade with, you'll have enough funds in there to trade with that copy trader. So that's the thing that I wanted to really give you guys an update on and make sure you do, because initially my profits would have been even bigger than this, to be quite frank with you. They would have been larger than what they are right now if I had known that. I skipped that process of transferring the funds over into each pair so that I'll have funds in there when the copy trader was ready to trade. I think I missed like a week of trading. So that's what it is. Let me know your thoughts on this though. Again, I'm thinking about putting my trading systems on here, but honestly, might not need to. Use the link in the comments below to sign up and fund your account. Again, you have to transfer. It depends on how you fund your account. If you're using USDT, then you have to transfer USDT over to your futures pairs for each of those, whichever ones the copy trader is using. If you funded your account with Bitcoin, Ethereum, whatever, you have to select Bitcoin or Ethereum from the coin list here up at the top and then move those Bitcoins in spot or Ethereum or Litecoin, however you funded your account, move those coins over to respective futures accounts that your copy trader is using. Just keep that in mind. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. It's Word Crypto Blood. I'm out of here. Holla.